What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I forgot to hit record when I first started the video. We're going to be evil today. We're using Chansey. This isn't a serious laddering session. This is more me just messing around with something that's been going around online and is very evil. Yes, it is a four Pokemon team, but man, if the person isn't prepared to deal with it, this team can mess some stuff up. So yeah, this isn't serious. This is more of a meme video, but we are on we are on my laddering account, and we have the same outfit as this dude. He's got some drip, dude. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video at any point in time, do me a favor, leave a like in it, subscribe to the channel, turn notifications, because I bring you guys daily Pokemon Sword and Shield content, and answer my comment question of the day. What is the most evil strategy that you've run in VGC? I want to know. Let me know in the comment section right now. I don't think I've actually ever run something super evil, but I've definitely run stuff that's like evil adjacent, if that makes sense. If you catch my drift. By leading off with the Rillaboom, they actually do have an option to stop my setup here. And that's just because Rillaboom's able to click, you know, Grassy Glide and stuff to completely mess me up. I think my play here is just to go for the raw Trick Room as I fake out their Rillaboom, not bother with the fancy setup that will allow me just to get it off normally. And yes, they're going to be able to actually set up a Snarl on me if need be. However, they end up going for the Heat Wave, which is interesting. They do get a crit on my Liepard, I think. That didn't look like regular damage. Or, oh my god, no, they're just Choice Specs. They're just Choice Specs on the Arcanine. That's kind of insane, but I almost don't mind it because part of the setup is losing the Liepard early on. That is part of the setup, technically. Oh my god, they really just said Choice Specs Arcanine. They really said, yeah, I'm going to use that. Man, I don't know what to do. I mean, I could just Misty Explode right now and go for the setup. That doesn't seem too awful. It also seems absolutely awful, to be honest. I mean, why not? I could Dynamax, but it would overcomplicate the situation that I'm in. I'm just not about that. Let me go ahead and go for a Growl on the Rillaboom and the Arcanine, because that will allow me to... as the Grassy Glide just goes first. Makes sense. Misty Explosion will allow my Chansey and my Shuckle in for free. And once I get that guard split off, I think it might just be game, considering what they have on their side of the field. Choice Specs Arcanine is not a tool you want to bring to fight this. If they are Choice Banned on the Rillaboom, that'd be quite interesting. I don't think they are. It's not common, but if they're running Choice Banned Arcanine, I'm more inclined to believe Choice Banned Rillaboom. I don't know. Hopefully they're not. What I'm going to do is just go immediately for the guard split and try to set up a soft build, since I'm assuming I'm going to have to take a Grassy Glide. And Chansey, as bulky as it is, on the physical side, it's a little bit held back by its very low physical defense, so... We're going to go for the guard split on our Chansey. And we're also going to soft boiled, hoping to catch a Grassy Glide, survive it, and then take much less damage on subsequent turns. And honestly, as long as they don't have Parish Song or anything too crazy, I should be able to win this just based off of them not getting any crits or anything. As they don't end up going for it, are they going to go for a knockoff? No, they go for the taunt. Unfortunately, they can't stop me since I am under Trick Room. That's the big thing here. They're going to go for the Specs Heat Wave. We already identified that, judging by the damage they did initially. That does a lot to the, Shuckle, but I think we're fine. Honestly, I'd prefer to get burned on this Chansey because that means they can't toxic me with anything crazy in the back, and the healer is going to come in clutch for the Shuckle there. I can still Dynamax, which is funny. Is there anything Shuckle can do here? Really? I can just go for a power split. No, I can't. I'm stupid. I suppose I can just Infestation the Rillaboom. And start setting up minimizes. Cool. They're just going to go for another Heat Wave. Minimize should be really good here. Like, yeah, I'm going to take a lot of damage from the Rillaboom, but them running Taunt makes me think that they're not actually running Knock Off. They go for the Heat Wave. I avoid, thanks to Minimize. Oh, no. I actually avoided with the Shuckle. Sorry, these names are in Japanese, so I actually can't tell what's going on. I legitimately can't tell what's going on. Let me look at what's in the back. I might actually just go for something on the Rillaboom to make sure I can win immediately. What Pokemon do they have again? They have all special attackers pretty much beyond the Rillaboom, so I'm going to go ahead and Infestation and go for the Seismic Toss, and that might actually help me out quite a bit here. Quick Claw activates. It's pretty lit. The Quick Claw is pretty much just there to ensure that there is somewhat of a chance that you'll get it off, even if the Trick Room doesn't go off. I do get a crit on that, and the Infestation will be holding onto that Rillaboom for a little bit. Seismic Toss should bring him down to about 25%, and then he should be fine to get Seismic Toss on the next turn. Taunt is very annoying, however. I think I've set up a situation where it's going to be very difficult for them to actually... Oh, do I live? I do not. It's going to be very difficult for them to stop me from winning. Now that I have my guard split off and I can just remove this Rillaboom from play, I should be fine to play the rest of this out pretty normally. And I think their Grassy Terrain should be ending any minute now. Twisted Dimensions return to normal. That is gone. Yeah, I mean, I have the guard split off. I feel pretty comfortable. Let me go for the Seismic Toss on the Rillaboom. I only have that option. Taunt is very annoying, but I think I'm okay as long as they don't do too much damage. And it's very hard to knock out a Chansey from this point. They do withdraw the Rillaboom. That was very smart of them because they're like, hey, you know what? I don't want to happen. You know what I really don't want to happen? I really don't want to have to deal with a Chansey absolutely messing up my Rillaboom because I can't knock it out without the Grassy Terrain Wood Hammer or something. Alright, I mean, there's only one thing I can do. Like, if I Dynamax, I can Max Knuckle. I'm pretty much going to have to exclusively use Dynamax as a defensive tool. I'll go ahead and just go for another one of these. I don't mind getting burned, really. I'm going to focus down on something that can set up on me, the Moltres in particular. Moltres could actually, like, just completely mess me up. There's the Berserk. Go for another one of these. They're likely going to Dynamax the Moltres and hit me on the special side of things, but it still shouldn't do too much, especially if I can start stalling them out with Soft Boiled. They would have to get in the Rillaboom. And granted, they can just absolutely steamroll me by, or not steamroll me, but snowball on me with the, what's it called? Max Darkness dropping my special defense, but I'm not taking this too seriously. I mostly just want to see how much BS you can play out of with this team. There's the Heat Wave. Specs Heat Wave once again doing zilch. How much will this do? This should do a lot more than that. Honestly, not as much as I thought, but it is still very concerning. I shake off the taunt, but I think I just lose anyways. I can go for like Soft Weld and stuff, but I've sort of set up a situation where it's very difficult for me to win. Because Specs Heat Wave, Max Darkness, you know, it's I can't avoid the Max Darkness. I'm taking every Specs Heat Wave, unless they miss. Pretty much they need to miss a lot of Heat Waves now to be able to get off a lot of Soft Boileds. There's the Whimsicott, likely carrying Taunt. So I'm almost tempted not to even go for it. And it is perfectly possible for them to miss every move after their next Max Darkness. That is something that could happen because I set up the Minimize. So I think it's in my best interest to go for the Soft Boiled anyways, just in case they're not actually carrying that. In case they're not actually carrying Taunt. Because it is likely that they, you know, might have Fake Tears or something. There's the Fake Tears. I actually avoid it, which is pretty big. I'm going to survive this Max Darkness. I think so, at least. And that was their last Max Darkness, which I was able to survive with Soft Boiled spam. I'm going to go for a Minimize here. I need them to miss whatever move they're going to go for next. And I'm going to have to play this pretty much entirely out by spamming these moves. You know, it's going to be a very annoying out, but I think it's the one I'm going to have to take. Go for the minimize to increase my chances of them missing. I'm also concerned with the Moltres missing. Moltres is my biggest fear on the field right now. They're going to go for the Dazzling Gleam and not connect. Moltres, can you miss as well? That's phenomenal. Let me get off the second minimize. And because my special defense is what's absurdly low right now, I would say Moltres is priority number one. Let me actually get off a soft-boiled. I'm going to sort of, you know, interchange these depending on what happens. They missed their Fake Tears. Can you miss another Fiery Wrath, please? Oh, they actually connected. Glad I went for soft-boiled. Hey. Alright, I'm going to go for another soft-boiled. And this looks like it's going to be a timer game, so I'm going to have to start clicking these Seismic Tosses really, 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 really fast. I'm going to go for a second soft-boiled, going to set up my final minimize, and then I'm going to start clicking. And I'm going to start clicking the Seismic Toss like there's no tomorrow. They don't connect. Please don't connect. Awesome. Get off a soft-boiled. I can go for one more minimize, and then I'll start clicking the Seismic Toss. I don't know how many minutes have passed. It looks like about 10 minutes, and these matches I think are 20. I kind of can't remember. Oh, I have 5 minutes of your time. Alright, so I'm gonna have to click really fast. And they are tinking. They are tinking. They withdraw the Whimsicott, likely gonna want to go for a taunt on me with that Rillaboom. I'm not too scared of Rillaboom's physical output anymore. So I am gonna focus down this. I am gonna focus down this Moltres more than anything. Hopefully they can whiff another attack here. They do actually connect, so that's a huge issue. I'm gonna have to go for another soft boiled to play things safely. And they do flinch me, so it's gonna be another situation where I have to click soft boiled. At this point, it's me versus the timer more than me versus the Moltres. Maybe I should actually just go for Seismic Toss on the off chance they connect. I think I'll just go for Seismic Toss. I need to start getting a lead. They whiff their Fake Out, which is huge. They go for a Nasty Plot. Now, I haven't maximized my chances of winning by minimizing my Chansey, but I have to start targeting things, or I'm not going to win. Rillaboom especially is going to be annoying. But I think this passive recovery actually helps me more than it helps them. Go for a Seismic Toss on the Moltres. See if they carry and protect. They do have protect. Let's see if they go for a taunt. They don't connect the taunt, which is great. I'm just going to go for another Seismic Toss on this Moltres, and hopefully I'll connect, because it's literally just me running against the clock now. Seismic Toss. I have 26 of these. There's no way they can survive 26. Like, with all their team. They connect a Fiery Wrath. That's going to be huge. Especially if I... Oh! They don't connect the taunt. Okay, I'm going to have to soft-boiled again. Okay, this is getting really intense. More intense than I really hoped it would be. I think I'll do one more match after this just because these matches are so absurdly long. Seems like we're about 13 minutes in. 14 minutes in, so... 6 minutes left. I'm just kind of keeping track of how long this video is by OBS, and it looks like they recognize their win cons. They're taking their time for everything now. However, if they do run out of your time, I end up winning. Yeah, they know how they need to win. Here's the Whimsicott. Let me go for the soft-boiled. I really hate that I have to soft-boiled again. Yeah, I think they're going to win by timer. I wasn't fast enough on the draw. Oh, no. Oh, they actually connect. Yeah, I end up losing just by them connecting a move, I think. Yep, that's game. That's game. There's no way I can win now unless they miss every single move from this point onward. And I connect every single, you know, I connect every single Seismic Toss without any opposition. I suppose there's no reason not to try it. Threat prioritization would say Rillaboom is number one, so I'll go for a Seismic Toss on Rillaboom. Like, yes, Whimsicott is targeting my lower defense stat, but Rillaboom is the Pokemon that's more likely to annoy me for the rest of the match. They don't connect. They do connect. I survive. It's going to take two more of those, and they are carrying Protect. It's not in my best interest to Dynamax, because I get a lot less done when I'm Dynamaxed. Seismic Toss on Arcanine is actually pretty big. Just because it means Rillaboom will have to come back in. And I have to avoid a lot of Heat Waves, which they're less likely to connect to Okay, they connected that. Good game. Alright, yeah. So unfortunately, I wasn't able to pick up a win on the first match. But I can try one more. I'll do one more since it takes so long to just get through these. Usually it takes like two. Or usually it takes like two or three matches for me to make a full video anyway. So we'll do one more and see if we can get a win with this evil setup. Yeah, I suppose I should give some insight onto how to beat this sort of thing. I'm just sacrificing my rating right now for this video. I should give some insight onto how to beat Chansey. Basically, this particular setup really doesn't like taunt, especially priority taunt, since the Hatterene has to set up a psychic train to stop it, which granted they could do it, but taunt is really, really big for stopping the Shuckle from being able to set up. Beyond that, Toxic is really nice since in 2v2 it's very easy to get Chansey alone, and just playing the timer is probably one of your better outs considering we do have your time and an actual battle timer active. This team probably has taunt somewhere with the Grimmsnarl, but I'm willing to try it anyways. Alright, one more. Continue battling, and hopefully I actually like can do something with this team so I don't have to scrap the whole video. I would only scrap the whole video if I accomplish literally nothing with the team. That's my whole deal. I will only scrap a video if I accomplish literally nothing. Because at what point do I just kind of say, yeah, this is not worth uploading because no one's going to get anything out of this. Okay, well, this isn't exactly the team I wanted to Nene on with this, but I suppose it'll work. This isn't exactly the team that this is meant to Nene on, but I mean, the only true threat to this is Urshifu. And that's if Urshifu can actually can connect a hit. And if Urshifu can survive the onslaught of Hatterene prior to this, so we'll just do it. We'll just do it. Yeah, I don't really see much counterplay to this. Urshifu is pretty much the height of the counterplay they have. I suppose Duraludon and Togedemaru could present sort of an issue. Taunt from Talonflame might be annoying. But Taunt actually isn't priority. So I should still be able to use the typical setup. Alright, they don't actually lead off with something that wants to go for... Or actually, this is kind of annoying. This is annoying purely because of Talonflame. I think my play here would be to... Because I really don't want the Talonflame to be able to spam flying moves, right? Because a flying... Like, Tailwind would get caught up by Copycat. And that would mess me up. I could just go for the Dynamax G-Max Smite. And fake out the Talonflame this turn. And that should make it so I always survive the hit with my Hatterene. And it'll also remove the Gale Wings from the Talonflame, making it so I can actually set up the Trick Room next turn. Or who knows, maybe I just go for a very sloppy setup. Get my fake out off. They've lost priority. And they've also just sacked their... they've also just sacked their number one counter to this, so I'm cool with it. I'm cool with it now. Get the G-Max Smite. And I know that I could just, you know, stay in with Hatterene and likely sweep the rest of the team if they're not prepared for this. But I really want to set up with the Chansey. That's the whole point of this video, so I might go for that endgame instead of the clear, obvious one right now. Yeah, there's the Cinderace. I think what I'm going to do here is go for a max smite onto... Alright, just go for the max Mindstorm onto you. And a Growl. Or maybe just copycat Trick Room. I'll just copycat Trick Room. I forgot I didn't set it up. So they withdraw the Cinderace, interesting. Not sure why they would do that. Alright, there's the Togedemaru. Unfortunately, a little bit late. It looks like they were going for a Protect, so that's a little bit unfortunate for them. I think that's one of the few moves, unless they have like Quick Attack or something, that's one of the few moves that actually would have stopped my copycat. It is at this point that I feel extremely comfortable just going for the hard switch into the Chansey. And I'll just click Growl. I don't mind that I'm ending my Dynamax early. I'm going for this particular endgame for content, guys. I am going for the content endgame. There are always two endgames when you're a VGC YouTuber. There's the right one, and then there's the content one. They went for Faint, okay. I mean, that's cool, because I honestly don't know. I don't know why you would run that. Alright, judging by their moveset, I want to say they don't have Taunt. I really want to say they don't have Taunt, but I can't really tell. Faint, Tailwind, Flare Blitz. Probably another flying move, I would assume. Go for the Minimize and the Guard Split right here. As long as they don't taunt the Shuckle, I should be fine. I think even if they taunt the Chansey, I'm alright. Look at Shuckle. I have never used you in a tournament, bro. And I get the Quick Claw off, so that's kind of funny. And because we're under Trick Room, even if they went for a priority move, my Guard Split went first, since I had plus one priority under Trick Room. Or no, that's not how it works. I think it just moves you to the top of your bracket, making it so it's not actually priority. Snap out of confusion, they go for the Brave Bird. I already got my Guard Split off. This is just ramming your bird into a wall. Alright, let me go for the Soft Boiled. I will go ahead and go for an Infestation onto Togedemaru. I'm assuming Togedemaru wants Dynamax. Don't get me wrong, Cinderace can still be an issue. But if it wants to go for a Max Knuckle into my Chansey, it's going to have to deal with Hatterene spamming Expanding Force at it. Or Dazzling Gleam, or whatever move I decide to lock into. There's the Infestation. Alright, we're back at full health. We can definitely take a hit from the Cinderace. They go for the Brave Bird once more as I avoid it. I feel pretty comfortable in saying that they're likely going to go for a Max Knuckle here. So I think what I'm going to do is Ally Switch and set up a Toxic. Or I could actually Power Split. I'm gonna do something else. I'm just going to go for the Minimize. And I'm going to Power Split to cut their attack stat. As they send back in the Togedemaru, interesting. I really would not understand if they didn't Dynamax the Cinderace here. There it is, okay. There's Big Rabbit Man, ready to stomp on me with his big feet. That sounded explicit. I really don't like that I said that. Okay, can you use big knuckle move, not big foot move. Big knuckle move, please. Power split's gonna cut your attack stat really hard. I'm gonna get a minimize off to make this endgame a lot better once your Dynamax is over. And then next turn I can go for taunt and the Toxic. Or not taunt. Toxic and Ally Switch. They do very little damage. The setup's kind of nasty, to be honest. As they take damage for the infestation. It actually does a lot even when they're Dynamax. That just looks like a lot considering the Dynamax health bar. I'll go ahead and I'll Ally Switch here to avoid a Max Knuckle. Go for the Toxic. They might have Fake Out on their Togedemaru, which could be annoying here, but it's not like I'm going to take too much from the Cinderace anyways. I feel like I'm my own worst enemy clicking Ally Switch right now, as they actually went for it into the Chansey. That's kind of funny. And like the prediction ended up doing nothing for them too, which is sad. It almost seemed like they intended on hitting the Shuckle, and they weren't trying to call it. Just judging by how the game was going. Alright, now that I've revealed Ally Switch, I don't want to ever click it again, just to mess with them. Let me go for the Infestation onto you. Or I suppose my best play is just to Power Split you. And I will minimize once more. Because after this, they're going to actually have to start connecting their moves. Yep, they hit the Shuckle. And I actually take a lot of damage since I split my my defenses with the Chansey. Go for the Iron Head, just eliminating the Shuckle from the field, that's fine. So I get my final minimize up, and they're going to actually have to start connecting their moves to beat me. And Hatterene can just come in. In fact, what I'm going to do here is Ally Switch Trick Room. I will click it one more time just to speed up this endgame. But all the pieces are really here already for me to win. They don't have any ghost types in the back. They can't really do anything. You know, besides actually connect a move. And even then, I've cut their attack stat on their most prominent physical attacker to the point where it's really not going to help them out too much, even if they do get it off. So we'll Trick Room here, go for the Ally Switch, and then I can just start clicking Dazzling Gleam or something. And the reason I'm going for Ally Switch here and not just setting up the Trick Room is, one, to make sure that my Hatterene doesn't get hit by a Steel move, and two, if they do connect a High Jump Kick anyways, it would just create a situation where, you know, I'm guaranteed to... Oh! Okay, nice Ally Switch call, that's fine. I was going to say, I'm just guaranteed to live the High Jump Kick. So unfortunately, I have to do this the old-fashioned way. I have to start connecting my my Seismic Tosses, so... You know what, I said I would go for the content endgame, and here it is. Here's the content endgame. Is this what you wanted? Is this what you wanted, you crazy people? You disgusting Chansey viewers? You watchers of big pink Pokemon? You viewers of round, rotund egg holders? I have nothing else. Alright. I mean, I think after the Toxic and this Seismic Toss, that should be a dead Cinderace. And hardly any time has really passed since the start of the game. Like, a decent amount of time, but not enough where I think they can win off a timer. Are they going to go for it? Nah, they swap out. Smart, smart, smart. But I really doubt they'll be able to connect the moves they need now. They go for the Iron Head. Do not connect. Seismic Toss. Now, this Togedemaru is somewhat of an issue for my game plan. And that's just because Togedemaru is actually a Pokemon who has a positive attack stat right now. I did not connect my power swap or my power split. I didn't get any of the necessary setup to really deal with that Pokemon. So... Really, I'm just banking on them missing every move, considering the minuscule chance they can actually connect one right now. I should probably deal with that thing. They're thinking about it. They're like, what do I do? I don't think they're trying to play the timer. I think they're just kind of flustered. It wouldn't make sense to play the timer at this point. And they withdraw. I'm cool with that because I'm just going to get more damage on the Cinderace. Oh, they connect one. That doesn't do any... Never mind, I'm not scared of Togedemaru. I'm not scared. Cinderace should drop to poison next turn, so I'll go ahead and I'll just soft boil now to play it safe. Or maybe not. Maybe they won't drop to poison, but... it's safer just to soft boil. Since I don't think they can knock me out in the current situation. High jump kick already has a decent chance to miss. So if they try to go for the high jump kick, they're going to end up losing their Cinderace if they miss anyway. So soft boil just is the safer play. What time is it? I have a class at 4 p.m. 3:06. Okay, I can probably get this video out by then. They're really thinking about it. I mean, there's not much commentary I can give here. As they switch out the Togedemaru, I really don't agree with that play. I honestly cannot agree with that play, and that's purely because the... Okay, well, I don't get that either. I think they could have just actually gone for the high jump kick, because they're just going to die in the sky now. They would have gotten a lot more reward out of trying to go for a high jump kick crit, especially since Bounce does significantly less, and has about the same chance to miss, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, he just died in the sky. Yeah, I would have just gone for the high jump kick. I suppose they can try to go for fake out stall, but now I just have to go for seismic tosses into the Talonflame. And yeah, if I connect like one seismic toss into Togedemaru, I pretty much win. Seismic toss into Talonflame. I think that's enough to KO it. I think even with a crit, they couldn't actually win at this point, purely because the guard split just makes Chansey so absurdly bulky that they, like, even if they crit past any kind of, like, defense boost, I would have set up if I had defense scroll. It wouldn't matter because I still have a naturally high defense stat. There's the fake out, they miss it. There's the feint, they connect it. I forgot, does feint check accuracy? I don't know. Seismic Toss does KO there, and I just have to click one on the Togedemaru, and I've won the match. There's a Seismic Toss, and that should be game. You know, unless they get really lucky. They just forfeit. Awesome. So we did get one successful setup with the Chansey. It was extremely sloppy, but it worked out in the end. But yeah. Let me know what you guys think about this team in the comment section down below. Clearly, you wouldn't just run four Pokemon. And once again, this wasn't meant to be the most serious of videos. More just trying out this really dumb team. But yeah, have a nice one. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.